Is using a G Suite account for personal use a terrible idea? Well, this article seems to think so from Android Authority, and I'm going to be reacting to it. I haven't read the article yet. I'm going to reply with my thoughts and let you know what I think about this. I've personally used a Google Workspace account for my personal use for many, many years now, and I've even recommended it on our channel as well and given a couple of videos on how and why you should do that. So let's see what this person's experience has been like. They haven't had a good one. If you're new to the channel, my name's Pete Moriarty. I help businesses systemize, organize, and scale using Google Workspace and other best practice technology tools as well. So let's get into this article together. Worst tech decision, a G Suite account for personal use. A small step towards email convenience led to a decade of ecosystem struggles. I kind of feel like I know what's coming with this. I feel like this is going to be related to home automation. For someone who's been struggling for a decade with this, hopefully they're surviving. Here we go. Okay, so it looks like they can attest that Google has killed off a number of services over the years, and many other services remain needlessly impeded. Google Workspace, or G Suite as it was known, for personal use. Here we go. Wow, this is an old screenshot. The original Google Apps. That's what it was called. That's what it looked like. But before it was Google Apps, it was actually called Google for Your Domain, or even I think maybe Google for Business was even before that. But I digress. Let's get into it. You can see here that it was suitable for small businesses. Ah, and look at this on the right, family or group. I never knew they advertised it for family or groups, but here we go. It says, some of you will suggest that you shouldn't have used Google Workspace as a personal account to begin with. I don't agree with that. I think it is a good idea to use a Google Workspace account to begin with because it gives you a range of benefits for you and your family, like increased security, the ability to, you know, collaborate on file shares and file storage in ways that you can't with a standard Gmail account, because you get access to the business tools like Google Shared Drives inside of Drive. But it also gives you basically a backdoor. If you work with a reseller like itGenius, then if you are ever locked out of your account for some reason, because an administrator account has been locked out or the account is disabled, you actually get a backdoor to support, which if you're using a personal Gmail account, you just don't get those options. And many a person has come to us and said, hey, I've been locked out of my Gmail account. I can't get access and I can't get through to Google support, or they're unwilling to help me for whatever policy reason they have. We've been unable to help them in some cases, unfortunately. Back when I signed up, Google actively marketed Google Apps and G Suite accounts to individual users and families who wanted their own personal domains. And you can still not have a Gmail account with a custom domain attached to it. No, that's what Google Workspace is for. So if you want a custom domain, you have to buy Google Workspace. That is just the way that it is. Okay, they're saying it's come back to bite them a number of times. Okay, so it says that they set up around 2009, and so they've probably been using Google Workspace around about the amount of time that I've been using it. That is pretty cool. 13-year long love-hate relationship. Goes through its ups and downs. It had a honeymoon period, and then G Suite over time got features later than the free Gmail service. And I think this is probably a good point to pause. That's been a frustration of mine over many, many years, that Google, while they were developing both of them in tandem, and yes, sure, Gmail was the primary service that they put out there to the world, what they ended up doing was actually holding back what was G Suite is now Google Workspace. And so Google would release a feature for Gmail, and we would have to wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait until it eventually came across to Google Workspace, which was infuriating because us as business users primarily forking out hundreds of dollars a year per license to Google were getting the raw end of the stick there. And that got really frustrating, especially when things like the assistant came out and, you know, everyone with a Gmail account was able to ask their assistant what was on their calendar for the day. But I wasn't able to do that as a business user, as a paying user. The free users were able to do it. And yeah, sure, it's not really free because of advertising, but the business users didn't get access to the features, and some of them just never came. And we would end up as business owners using a G Suite account for personal use or using it in the business as well, waiting and waiting and waiting, waiting on the magicians at Google to release these features, sometimes for years, which is pretty crazy. Anyway, but let's dig a little bit deeper. So this person says the real trouble started when Google started rolling out its broader portfolio of products. So you can see here in 2017, Google introduced Google Pay, and it was part of a, all their payment system and bringing unified payments into India, it seems like. But it didn't work for G Suite accounts. It only worked for Gmail accounts. And this is the case with a number of different products. Here we go. This is the message that they got. Does not support Google Workspace. It should be added in the next few months. I wonder how long that will take for it to happen. Okay, cool. So fast forward to 2018. Google rolled tears into Google Pay. Should have solved the issue, but no, it didn't. It still hasn't been added. So we're halfway through 2022 and Google have not yet added this particular feature in there. Wow, that is pretty crazy. The interesting thing for me is that I happen to be based in Australia and Google Pay has actually worked for me for my Android device. I don't know if that's something different. Maybe it's Google Wallet is separate to Google Pay. But what I do know is, at least for the Australian market, I have been able to access payment tools inside of Android, payment tools online as well, using Google's ecosystem. So it may be that there's something different based on the actual locations here. Now, before we go any further, it's pretty important for me to make an explanation of some of the reason why Google may not add features over to Google Workspace, or would at least be delayed in adding features to Google Workspace. And that is due to business security and business compliance. Now, Google have, across all of their tools in the business world, a SLA, which is a service level agreement. And a service level agreement basically means if this tool goes down, then you will be compensated for a period of time for each day that the tool is unavailable. So if that's something like Google Drive or Gmail or Google Docs, that will give you a guaranteed service. Not many people know about that, but it is hidden away in Google's documents for support for Google Workspace. Now, when Google release new features and new tools to the Gmail app, there's no guarantee that they're going to be up or down for any period of time. But before they integrate something into the business version of Google Workspace, well, they're going to have to make sure that it bloody works to actually be integrated into Workspace before they go ahead and roll it out. Because if it is a tool that could be deemed to be mission critical, then customers would get very upset, being business paying customers, if the tool was unavailable for a period of time. So that's part of the reason. Number two is administration control. So when you have a Google Workspace account, most of the time you're going to have a administrator of some sort administering it. If you're a small business, it's going to be probably the business owner. If you're a larger business, you would have like a consultant or an IT team, and they would be the ones who are actually managing the account. And so they'll be deploying policies. When a new feature is released, they need to educate the users that they're managing. And imagine if you're in a company with hundreds of employees, you're going to have to be educating them. And so with all of that, there is documentation needed. There are release announcements needed. There's communication needed to the administrators. And then, you know, there's like help guides. Google need to gear up their support teams and their support centers to be able to support any features that are rolled out to Workspace. So you can see that Google's got a lot of extra work that they need to do for their business customers that they don't really need to do for their personal consumer customers with a Gmail account. And so that's also another reason for the delay, is that there's all those extra steps that are required for Google to actually deploy a feature to the business accounts. Okay, so now it's time to talk about Google Home, and this one is going to be a doozy. So the Google Home speaker first released in the writer's country of India in 2018. I myself personally also picked one up straight away. But yes, as I mentioned earlier, it didn't support calendars for G Suite accounts. That was one of the best features of the Google Home. They basically said that you would be able to speak to it and have your calendar show up. And I still use the nighttime feature. I say goodnight to Google and it lets me know that, you know, it's turned off all the lights in my house via automations, and it asks me what time I want to set the alarm for tomorrow. But unfortunately, it won't tell me my schedule for the next day, which it still does not do. Now, this is pretty funny. Ironically, the Echo Dot is able to pull up the G Suite calendar and actually read back what's on your calendar, which is pretty crazy. Okay, that's not the end of their troubles with the Google Home ecosystem. You are unable to invite family members to your Google Home account if you set it up via Google Workspace. And yes, that is absolutely crazy. Not only have I run into this issue where I want other people to help manage my home and it just doesn't let them, but I've also had the issue where on one of my Workspace accounts, it doesn't even pull my photos into my Chromecasts properly, and so I can't display my photos on my TV as a digital wallpaper. Tried going through Google support and they've not been able to help me out with that at all. I think it's because I've got an account that's probably over 10 years old and there's some kind of bug in it. But do you think they would be able to help me? No. And the reason for that is because it's a Google Workspace account and attaching it to Google Home is not supported, which means that you can do it, you can give it a go, but you're not going to get any support from it from the Google Help Desk team because it's just outside of their standard operating procedure. So here's the next challenge. A number of apps are unable to let you sign in with a Google Workspace account, and I have also come up with the same challenge myself. Google Nest just does not work for me, full stop. Doesn't allow me to create an account using my Workspace account, and yeah, it just doesn't actually do anything. You have to use a Gmail account, doesn't work. Again, no option, and there just isn't any support for Workspace accounts for that to work. Authors also complaining about Google One not working, which means yes, you miss out on sharing Google Drive storage, Google YouTube Premium, YouTube Music. And what really sucks is that you can't share your libraries with your, with your families. Like, you just don't have the ability to pool storage or all of the other features that consumers would normally get access to. Okay, so they've got a survey here. Do you regret using G Suite account for personal use? And I'm saying yes, but I'm locked in, unfortunately. And it's not like I'm really, really locked in. I could export it out to Gmail if I wanted to. But I guess I'm locked in spiritually to my Google Workspace account because I like the features of it and the security benefits and, you know, the additional stuff that it lets me do, even though I have to deal with some pretty damn frustrating limitations when it doesn't work with things like Nest cameras or connecting in Google Home, or my calendar still doesn't work. You can see here most of the votes are pretty similar. The only poll option that won out was people who haven't used one for personal. So yeah, this is a pretty big issue. You can see here, yes, but people are locked in, but also yes, but I've migrated away. Total of those is nearly 50% have expressed frustrations. Okay, so what can you do? Short of us starting a class action and suing Google because they haven't delivered the features to the business version that they originally advertised back in 2008 when this person signed up for it. Well, I'm not sure. You gotta kind of put up with it. My personal opinion is that you get a lot of pretty excellent features with your Workspace account, which allow you to do more, even if you are using it in a personal context. But if you really want to get the most out of all of Google's features in your home and connecting your identity to Google's consumer products, well, you may consider switching to a Gmail account instead. Google have some pretty cool features being added to personal Gmail accounts like Google One, which gives you additional storage and other options as well. The ability to share things with your family too is a good idea. Personally, being very geeky, I prefer to stick with my Workspace account, but I would absolutely understand that most people, it would probably make sense to switch over to a Gmail account. Now, if you're interested in some help switching from a Workspace account to a Gmail account, we happen to help businesses and consumers migrate their data from Google accounts and between Google accounts every day of the week. If you're interested in some help for a migration service, we usually do this for businesses, but if you're someone who's happy to invest a bit of time and money for us to help out with that, please make sure you get in touch. But if not, if you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and more about Google's tools in general, please make sure you check out the rest of our channel. Give me a thumbs up if you like this comment. Drop a comment down below with all of your thoughts. Let me know what you think about this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this content. And if you need more help with your Google Workspace account, there's four ways that we can help. Number one, join our free community group where others in the community help support each other with their Google Workspace accounts. And I'm in there from time to time answering questions as well. Number two, take advantage of our free transfer in offer to get a bunch of additional value for your Workspace account just for transferring your billing over to itGenius. Number three, you can take advantage of a free consultation if you qualify, or an IT systems check and audit for everything technology in your business. Number four, if you need help right now, you can either join our concierge program or book a one-time fix-it service to get support from our professional support team for everything Workspace and the Google ecosystem. See you in the next one.